Welcome, beautiful souls. Today I would like to introduce you a galactic race that connected with me telepathically, because for me it's easy to connect through telepathy with different kind of races, galactic races, I mean. So let's begin. This race lives in the Canis Minor Constellation. The Canis Minor is a small constellation that is placed in the northern celestial hemisphere. And it has two main stars. The main one is Procyon, but also there's another one that is Gomeza. But this race that I would like to talk about is placed in another star that is fainter than this or this the other one, and the star is named Luitens, after the person that discovered it. So let's begin. In reality, I don't know exactly how to pronounce the name of this race, because it's Y-S-Y-S. So I don't know. Maybe in Spanish it's really easy, but in English maybe it's Wise, or maybe Ysys. I don't know, really. So I will name them wise. So I hope they don't hate me for that. So let's begin. This race, according to the book of Elena Danan, the Encyclopedia Galactica, this race is a human reptiloid indigenous of the planet that live in perfect symbiosis with their environment in a planetary hive consciousness. What it means, living in a planetary hive consciousness? It means that they are like a living part of the planet, or like they are an incarnated part of the planet, living in the surface, being in movement, the planet movement, moving through the surface of it, as a way of saying. Because when we have a deep connection with the consciousness of the planet, it's like we are part of the planet. We are a living part of the planet, incarnated and living on the surface. So they are hermaphrodites and produce up to 3 offsprings in a lifetime. And they are very spiritual. They believe in peace, in mutual respect and compassion. They are members of the Galactic Federation of Worlds and the Andromedan Council. They are a spacefaring nation. And they are involved in the envoys to Earth. But let's continue about the transmission that one of them sent to me. They are telepathic and also vocal. Their telepathy comes from the connection from the pineal gland to the heart. So they say that telepathy in reality begins when we communicate our hearts from our minds, from our pineal and pituitary glands, in reality, both of them, when we connect both of them to our hearts and we are able to listen to our hearts and, yeah, and being friends with our hearts, but also with our entire being. Because a broken heart means that there is a broken being inside us. For them, for example, it's easy to enter into states, altered states of consciousness. And also there's a message from them that say, go within to find and see the beauty of your heart and share it to the world. They can be healers of the heart. And they say, bring the essence of your heart to the surface. Don't hide it anymore. And then this being allows me to meditate with him. If you all want to meditate, to connect with him. So let's begin the meditation. It will be a meditation that it will help us to connect much better with our hearts and heal our hearts. Because normally most of us, we have maybe not a broken heart, but maybe some trauma, some wound. So it's important to heal our hearts and reconnect them with our pineal and pituitary glands. So let's begin. Close your eyes and begin to breathe in and out slowly, deeply. Focus your attention on your lungs. How they move every time you breathe in and breathe out. How they move every time you inhale and exhale. And remember, you always can choose the kind of energy that enters within your lungs through the air you breathe. So we can choose to breathe in light and love. And it would be these energies, the ones that feed our entire body, that nourish not only our lungs and clean and nourish our blood, but also our entire being. So we breathe in light and love. And we exhale the energies that no longer serves us. Remember that you are always surrounded by light and love. They are the main energies of this universe. They are the foundation of this universe. they exist in every tiny particle. They exist everywhere, even when we feel ourselves in a dark place or dense environment. Light and love always are here, and we can choose to fill up our bodies, to nourish our bodies with them. So we inhale light and love, and in this ceaseless movement, inhaling, exhaling, we feel our hearts. We feel the beat of our hearts. And now we invoke this beautiful being, the wise being, or invoke one wise being that is here ready for us to connect with. And let him or her, In reality, they are hermaphrodites. We let them to place a hand over our hearts to help us to heal, while at the same time we focus our attention and intention to bring to the surface of our heart its essence, its precious essence. And we continue breathing in and out, focusing our attention in our hearts. while allowing ourselves to let go every feeling, emotion that we have within our hearts that no longer serves us. While this being is helping us, it's our side, in our side, center of your brain. Imagine its energy, and with our intention, we bring the energy of the pineal gland to our heart, connecting them both. This way, establish a better communication with our hearts, a better communication between brain and heart, mind and feelings, or mind and soul. We breathe in and out from our hearts with intention of not only bring to the surface our heart essence, but also to expand it beyond our physical heart. Maybe if we have a lot of fears of showing ourselves as we really are, it's difficult for us to expand our heart's essence, but don't worry, keep doing it. feel. Feel the love that surrounds you. You are loved. You are loved for what you are. You are loved for who you are. Little by little, we return to the here and now. Maybe we need to breathe in and out deeply. It is said that if you forge a bond with these beings as a friend, this bond lasts beyond life and death. And once you're ready, you can open your eyes. Have a lovely day.